Fortunately, Senator Akintekwa was there and I was there. And Senator came to me to say, look, I think Jonathan is losing this battle. And I responded to him that perhaps I have never experienced any loss in a battle. Today, we shall shape this election. And by the grace of God, when we have spoken to a few people, they now have no option but to shape the fate of the election. So it is an achievement, for the Yoruba people. Because if that election was not shifted, I would bet you that Jonathan would have lost that election. The rhythm had been perfected. In war torn areas of the Northeast, you had Yobe being given 80%. The population had been given 80% BBC, and in Lagos, the most highly populated part of this country, was experiencing only 62%, and even the governor himself, Dr. Katana, was still trying to be given his own BBC. So the few BBCs we have must be maximized. That's why I am appealing to everybody, even the name should be carried. Let us all go there, and this time cast our votes in favor of a friend. Jonathan has not a friend. I'm not carried away by the fact that somebody is not corrupt. If people are turning history upside down, who is not corrupt? Who is not corrupt? Have you forgotten the $2.8 billion? Have we forgotten the 52 suitcases in new currency? Have we forgotten the chairmanship of the PTM? And have we forgotten that somebody recently said that if he doesn't win the election, or if the election doesn't favor him, that the blood of Mabul will mix with the blood of dogs? Whereas Jonathan said, my ambition to become president of this nation should not cost one drop of any Nigerian's blood.